Hi, and welcome to Trex Academy, where you can learn everything you need to know about building your deck project. I'm Devin, and I'm here with Lindsay. And in this video, you'll learn when to frame using a flush beam configuration versus a drop beam configuration. So these two configurations are pretty typical to see on a deck project, and the terms are really relative to the joist. So I'll show you exactly what I mean. So this is a flush beam, right? And the reason that it's a flush beam is the top of that beam is going to be flush with the top of our joist.
Okay.
Take a look here at this drop beam that we have here. Mm-hmm. Same thing. You can see our joists are on top of that, so this beam is dropped below those joists.
Got it.
Okay, so all relative to position of the joist.
So why did you choose to use both options for this project?
Yeah, it really all depends on the project that you're working on. There are a few key things that you can look at to help you determine which type you should be using for the project.
Okay.
One of those is going to be the available space that you have under the deck. Makes a lot of sense, right? And you also have consider, like, do you need more available space off the front?
Okay.
And that additional flexibility that one type could offer over the other.
Okay.
And then finally, just aesthetics. Obviously, that's going to be subjective, but it's going to be important for the design of your deck.
Okay. Yeah, okay? Makes sense.
All right. So why don't you come in, take a look, kind of go through those key factors to see what we find.
Is this a test?
Absolutely.
All right.
All right. Come check it out. Okay, so let's start by talking about how much space we have available under the frame.
All right, well, on this deck, we have plenty of space for the beam to go under the joist.
Yes.
Not so much on this one right here.
You're pretty tight.
Yes, and definitely no space under that ground level deck over there.
Exactly.
So I would say that it makes way more sense to have flush beams on these two areas.
Yeah, you nailed it. You can actually see our beam right here, the height of that beam. If you'd imagine that being underneath this frame, really difficult to fit, right?
Yeah.
And it would be impossible to fit, just like you said, on that ground level deck.
Yeah.
That next area, which was the extra area on the front of the deck.
Additional space.
Additional space, yeah.
Well, since we're using a drop beam on this deck here, we can gain some additional space by putting in a cantilever.
Yeah, exactly, which we've actually done here. Not only does that allow us to have that additional space past the beam, but it gives us more flexibility, which can be great for DIYers. I'll show you what I mean by that. We're actually able to adjust the front of that deck because I wanted to make sure I was using full deck boards all the way from the front against the house, right?
Yeah.
So to do that, it's really easy because of our cantilever. I can adjust that after I've already planned for my deck.
Okay.
But in the case of a flush beam, even though you can do it, you have to do that at the beginning of your planning phase. Again, just to make sure that you have full deck boards all the way across.
Got it.
And adjust that once you've already made that connection.
Makes sense.
Okay. And then finally, we just have the aesthetics of the two.
Yes.
What do you think?
Well, for me personally, I like a cantilever. I think it adds a little dimension, some shadow, some depth.
Absolutely.
I find it way more aesthetically pleasing. So I would gear more toward a drop beam if the project allows for that.
No, that's a good point, because there are going to be some circumstances where you might prefer one over the other, but your project is going to dictate that you're going to maybe have to use a flush beam, or maybe you need to use one of our drop beams here, right?
Yep.
Okay, good note. Well, you passed that test with flying colors, so
excellent.
Got another one for you.
Okay.
As you're framing that deck, if you're using a flush beam configuration versus that drop beam, what do you think the differences in installation might be?
Well, I know the ledger board connection, the flashing, all of that will be the same.
Yeah, perfect.
The post to beam connections, you could use the same things, but I noticed here that the beam is right on top of the
top
post.
Top of the post, right.
Versus on our drop beam deck, the beam is on that notch that
notch.
We put in there.
Yeah, yeah. So it is pretty typical for me when I'm installing a drop beam to use that notch.
So why wouldn't you use a notched post on a flush beam deck?
Okay, well, you can use either, and you actually could even use that notch if you wanted to.
Okay.
Both of these methods are approved, and now that we have our joist in between our beams, that's one more point of interference that we could have if one of those joists meet right at a post.
I see.
So why not use another approved method? And in this case, we don't have to worry about those joists landing on that notch post.
All right.
Okay.
Well, then I guess the only difference that I can really think of here is that you're using double the amount of joist hangers.
Right. Because a little more hardware there.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So you have a hanger on each side versus just on the ledger board in our drop beam deck.
Right.
You also, on the flush beam, won't need to use hurricane ties.
Okay, so a little less hardware on that side. Right.
Yeah.
Kind of equals itself out, right? So one more big difference, though, You can see we've got our blocking over top of the beam in between all of our joists. We don't need that because of this configuration. Pretty much the same configuration, same number of beams, same beam material, but it just changes things up, again, based on what you pointed out.
Yeah, pretty straightforward.
All right, so now we're gonna move on to multi-level deck framing. And if you'd like to see a video on that and a whole lot more, you can go to trex.com/academy. Thanks for watching.